And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Sauroniops, which was a request from Tyrant King via our Patreon and Discord, so thanks. It was a Carcharodontosaurid theropod that lived in the Late Cretaceous in what is now Morocco in the Kem Kem Beds. It looks a lot like Carcharodontosaurus. It's got that elongated skull and sharp teeth, but it had a kind of a dome on its head.
Interesting. So it's like sort of like a cross between a pachycephalosaur and a Carcharodontosaurus?
In the paleo art, it does not look pachycephalosaur-like.
So what kind of dome does it have?
It's more like a bump on its head.
Okay.
So small-ish.
It's important to other sauroniops, but not so obvious to other animals, maybe.
Well, it's got this thick vaulted skull roof and then bump on the head. The holotype is MPM2594. It's a nearly complete left frontal bone, part of the skull, which is just above the eye socket. That's what the description is based on. And it's described as thick and broad. And the fossil was about 7.5 inches or 19 centimeters long. Someone had bought the fossil from a Moroccan fossil dealer and then donated it to the Museo Paleontologico di Montevarchi in Italy. The fossil had been collected by locals, so the exact location of where it was found was unknown. Sauroniops was described and named in 2012 by Andrea Cow, Marco Dalla Vecchia, and Matteo Fabbri. When they were first describing this fossil in 2012, the author said, quote, "Although the combination of features present is unique and should support the institution of a new species, pending more complete specimens, we feel it would be inappropriate to erect a new taxon," end quote. But then later in that year, they reanalyzed the fossil and found it was unique enough to be named.
I like it when people are cautious about naming new dinosaurs.
Mm-hmm. They decided to reanalyze it because several papers showed that Carcharodontosaurids had distinct frontal bones and that could be used to tell them apart.
Mm.
And they said in the 2012 paper, quote, "Due to the numerous autapomorphies in their skeletons, Carcharodontosaurids can be identified even from isolated bones." And they said that the type specimens for Eocarcharia, Carcharodontosaurus iguidensis, and Veteropriestosaurus were unique enough to be named from isolated bones. The type species is Sauroniops pachytholus. And being a Carcharodontosaurid, it was carnivorous and bipedal. You might notice from the name, Sauron, the genus name means Sauron eye, and it's named after the character Sauron from Lord of the Rings.
Nice.
That's because the only known fossil is from above the eye socket.
Oh, that's funny. Like the Sauron tower with the big eyeball.
Mm-hmm. And then the species name means thick dome.
So they did. It's a little bit like pachycephalosaurs because they have the same pachy in it.
That's true. I guess when I was looking at different paleo art, it just, I have a vision in my head of how thick the pachycephalosaur dome is, and it's a little different.
Yeah, it's not nearly as wide. It's not like the whole head feature. It's like a smaller, I think your bump description was apt.
Yeah. Sauroniops was originally thought to be a derived member of Carcharodontosauridae, but the later 2012 paper, the one that named it, found it to be a basal Carcharodontosaurid and related to Eocarcharia.
That is confusing because usually you put the author's name in the year to name a paper, but they talked about it twice in the same year with the same authors.
Yep. So you got to be extra specific.
Yeah.
Sauroniops lived at the same time and place as Carcharodontosaurus. Compared to other theropods found in the Kem Kem Beds, the frontal bone was only known in Carcharodontosaurus, but it had this small dome that protruded from the middle of the fossil. So this bump on the head could be for display or headbutting, but it's really hard to know for sure based on the one fossil.
I guess nowadays that when they think that pachycephalosaurs might not have even used their heads for bumping, this one may not have as well.
Yeah.
At least not at a full, you know, charge sort of thing.
Yeah, true. The nasofrontal suture of Sauroniops extended along 40% of the frontal length, so the nasal bone was contacting the frontal bone for over 40% of the frontal length. As you can imagine, because it's just the one bone around the eye, it's really hard to estimate the body length for Sauroniops. But based on the length, width, and thickness of the skull bone, the specimen was found to be similar in size to the frontal bones of really big Carcharodontosaurid specimens with well-preserved skulls. And based on that, they estimated Sauroniops to be 33 to 39 feet or 10 to 12 meters long. The holotype is thought to be an adult based on the size of the frontal being about the same size or larger than the size of frontals in adult Carcharodontosaurus. As you can imagine, because there's only the one bone, there's some debate over the validity of Sauroniops.
Yeah.
A 2020 study by Nizar Ibrahim and others found Sauroniops to be a junior synonym of Carcharodontosaurus sahericus. They looked at the neotype skull of Carcharodontosaurus sahericus and found the frontal of Sauroniops to be 60% the size of the frontal of Carcharodontosaurus sahericus and said, quote, "This size disparity casts in a new light what amount to minor differences between these specimens."
Yeah, then you get into the whole, was it just a younger version of the same thing with some subtle differences because it's young?
So they found that the unique features of Sauroniops were not different enough from Carcharodontosaurus sahericus. Andrea Cao, however, did not agree with the synonymization.
That often happens when people finally put their nickel down and say, I think this is a valid new species. It's hard. It can be hard to unring that bell.
Yeah, so maybe there will be future papers about this dinosaur.
Hopefully future fossils are found.
Mm-hmm. Although, what if they only find the bone over the other eye?
That would be funny.
For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.